Liturgy. The following are the announcements for this Sunday. All youth finishing 8th through 12th grade are invited to attend Steubenville of the Rockies, a Catholic summer youth conference. Experience powerful talks, life-changing sacramental moments, inspiring praise and worship music, alongside thousands of fellow Catholic teenagers. The deadline to sign up is Monday, January 16th. Please see the bulletin for more information and to get registered. The Knights of Columbus Pancake Breakfast is today from 8:30 to 11:30 in the Social Hall. Proceeds will benefit the pro-life ministry. The readings for our liturgy are in Breaking Bread, page 57. As brothers and sisters in Christ, please stand, welcome one another, and introduce yourself to anyone you do not know. Our priest celebrant is Father Tim. Our deacon is Brad Schaefer.
Number 208, God we praise you. 208.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Sisters and brothers, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these beautiful mysteries.
Lord Jesus, you are the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ Jesus, you call us to obedience and holiness of life. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, your salvation reaches to the ends of the earth. Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who govern all things both in heaven and on earth, mercifully hear the pleading of your people and bestow your peace on our times. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Thank you.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. The Lord said to me, "You are my servant, Israel, through whom I show my glory. Now the Lord has spoken, who formed me as his servant from the womb, that Jacob may be brought back to him and Israel gathered to him. And I am made glorious in the sight of the Lord, and my God is now my strength. It is too little, the Lord says, for you to be my servant, to raise up the tribes of Jacob and restore the survivors of Israel. I will make you a light to the nations, that my salvation may reach to the ends of the earth." The word of the Lord.
Put a new song into my mouth, praise of our God. Here I am, Lord, here I am, Lord, I come to do your will. You delight not in sacrifice and offering, but in an open ear. You do not ask for holocaust and victim. Then I said, "See, I have come. Here am I, Lord. Here am I, Lord. I come to do your will." In the scroll of the book it stands written of me. I delight to do your will, O my God. Your instruction lies deep within me. Here I am, Lord. Here I am, Lord. I come to do your will. Your justice I have proclaimed in the great assembly. My lips I have not sealed. You know it, O Lord. Here I am, Lord. Here I am, Lord, I come to do your will.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Paul, called to be an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, and Sosthenes, our brother, to the church of God that is in Corinth, to you who have been sanctified in Christ Jesus, called to be holy, with all those everywhere who call upon the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, their Lord and ours. Grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. John the Baptist saw Jesus coming toward him and said, "Behold, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. He is the one of whom I said, 'A man is coming after me who ranks ahead of me because he existed before me.' I did not know him. But the reason why I came baptizing with water was that he might be made known to Israel." John testified further, saying, "I saw the Spirit come down like a dove from heaven and remain upon him. I did not know him, but the one who sent me to baptize with water told me, 'On whomever you see the Spirit come down and remain, he is the one who will baptize with the Holy Spirit.' Now I have seen and testified that he is the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
We're in the second Sunday of the ordinary time of the church liturgical year. Our readings are beautiful today, this morning. We continue to hear God's plan of salvation. God's plan of salvation is never, it never runs out. It's never boring. It's always fresh. It's eternal. In fact, God's plan of salvation is folding right now, unfolding. We are being saved at this very moment. Our readings can help us, give us a focus and a commitment to God as disciples of Christ in 2023. We've done some early in the January 1st, some resolutions. But this is a good month yet to do some commitments, faith commitments, that we're going to take throughout the year 2023. So let's take a quick look at the readings. They'll help us. In that first reading from the book of Isaiah, the prophet Isaiah, chapter 49, he writes, God's plan of salvation, which we said is perfect, is unfolding. It's beautiful. God's plan of salvation leads humanity to experience strength in God. We can pray for spiritual strength. Spiritual strength will help us carry our crosses. Spiritual strength God will give us in times of temptations or doubts or whatever we experience this new year. Spiritual strength is God's gift to us. God doesn't want us to be spiritually weak like the devil, but he wants us strong. You know, we can make that commitment. Give me strength, Lord, in my weakness. That could be our prayer for the rest of the year. Lord, make me strong in my weakness. In the second reading, St. Paul's first letter to the Corinthians, chapter 1, St. Paul gives us just a little deeper spiritual insight into God's plan of salvation. As he writes, sanctified in Christ is a call to holiness. Now, we've been sanctified at our baptism. We've been given that gift of holiness, faith. So we have it. We've been given this sanctifying grace in Christ. That's our call to holiness. Not once in a while, but every day. Every time our heart beats, every time we take a breath, holiness. Holiness. We can make that commitment ourselves to Christ. And for the grace, we can pray for the grace always, always to be in a state of sanctifying grace, growing in holiness throughout this year. That's a simple commitment. We can do that. And then in St. John's Gospel, chapter 1, now God's plan of salvation takes on human flesh. We hear that from St. John the Baptist. He points this out in case humanity misses it. And we know the words, we hear it every time we attend Mass. Behold, the Lamb of God. Jesus is the one who takes away the sins of the world. He is the Son of God. There's no doubt. St. John points this out. The year 2023, our commitments that we can do, we can make, we can do these easily. And we can do them with this theme in mind. Behold the Lamb of God. Maybe that'll be our theme, our commitment this year. Behold the Lamb of God. What is that going to look like in this year? We're not sure, but here are some examples. The pro-life march. We have some parishioners that'll be attending that. Some of our youth are going to be attending the pro-life march in Washington, D.C. Now, we're going to watch that live as it unfolds, the march. And maybe to ourselves, or if we're with somebody, we're going to say, look, Behold, Jesus is in the crowd. Jesus is the crowd. Or maybe we'll be holding a newborn baby, our granddaughter, our grandson, a newborn baby. Or maybe we'll be holding the hand of a dying family member or a friend. Maybe we'll be embracing someone who is deeply grieving the death of a friend or a family member. And to ourselves, we're going to say, behold, what you're doing is embracing Jesus. Maybe this year, as we go to confession a number of times, just before we enter into the confessional, standing in line, we can pray this simple prayer. Behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. And then in the confessional, we'll hear those beautiful words, I absolve you of your sins. Eucharistic adoration. Now we're in the National Eucharistic Revival. We're in the first year of a three-year revival. Go, Eucharist! Maybe this is the year to make that commitment. Enter into a personal Eucharistic adoration. Find a time, maybe once a month, maybe twice a month, I don't know, 15 minutes, maybe an hour. And just sit before Jesus in the Holy Eucharist. Our hearts will sing with joy. No one's going to hear it. God will hear it. Jesus will hear it. This is the song we'll sing. Behold, the Lamb of God is present before me, embracing me with his Eucharistic love. Just simple things that we could commit to with that theme of behold the Lamb of God. So we can take this week, maybe this is a good week, to make a faith commitment for 2023. Just do one thing, very simple. Maybe just pray the rosary once a month for 12 months. Or maybe Eucharistic adoration. Who knows what it's going to look like? But make a commitment. Remember, God is never outdone with generosity or charity. And always remember, sometimes I forget this, because we get caught up in just the daily routine, that God is always, always full of surprises. All he needs from us is commitment. Commitment to him in 2023. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. And as committed disciples of Christ, in prayer, together we stand and profess our faith in one voice. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty. Our Lord came among us to create a new kind of friendship where God and humanity become one. So let us bring our prayers to God this morning.
For the church and her leaders, that their actions and words may be a light to all the nations of the saving power of God, we pray to the Lord. For our nation, that the life of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. may be a model for breaking down barriers, embracing nonviolence, and achieving justice. We pray to the Lord. For a greater respect for all human life as the precious gift of God that it is, especially the lives of the unborn, we pray to the Lord. For all Christians, joined by a common baptism with water and the Holy Spirit, that they may grow ever closer together and find unity in our faith, we pray to the Lord. For this assembly gathered here in faith, that we may respond willingly and faithfully to God's call, we pray to the Lord. For those who have died, we pray to the Lord. For the prayers written in our Book of Petitions, for the people of St. Wenceslaus Parish, and for the unspoken needs we now hold within the silence of our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Almighty God, Father of all, though we cannot see you in this world, may we at least glimpse your Son, Jesus, from time to time in the people we love. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. We'll have our children's collection, please. Pray, brethren, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries, for whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy, through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power of the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy, and you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your holy name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. Peter and St. Paul, St. Sava, he's a bishop, St. Odilia, she can help us, those with eye health issues, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, all the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Thank you. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Sins of the world have
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord.
Our communion song number 473, I Has Not Seen, 473. Yet ever knew the music.
Just a reminder, I think this morning we're having pancakes, right? Knights of Columbus having pancakes. I have no idea where it's at. the knights over there, they'll get you to the right direction. Okay, so enjoy your dancing pancakes. Let us pray. Pour on us, Lord, the spirit of your love, and in your kindness, make those you have nourished by this one heavenly bread, one in mind and heart, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you.
Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your life. Thanks be to God.
A closing number, 564, All the Ends of the Earth, 564. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the master of the seas, has come with justice for the world. Break into song at the deeds of the Lord, the wonders God has done in every age. All the ends of the earth, all you creatures of the sea, lift up your eyes to the wonders of the Lord, for the Lord of the earth, the master of the sea, has come with justice for the world.